with over 40% of the population being Hispanic, I think it's huge. I think a lot of times when we first started, people were afraid of us. When we first started, we really had to go knocking on doors, and we really had to work hard for every dollar we got and to show that we were viable business owners.
But the vision of the chamber was to help the small business community, the small businesses that were too afraid to go get involved with the big chambers. At first, even I was hesitant because I was a little concerned because, you know, we didn't have too much involvement. But Augie, you know, one of the founders of the chamber, he used to tell me, stick it out, it's gonna grow, it's gonna grow.
Back then, since there were not a lot of Hispanic businesses, it was easier to bring us together under one common goal. From the very beginning, my former partner and I, René Rivial, who ended up being president of the Chamber of Commerce of Guadalajara, a 10,000 member organization, he and I believed that Tucson could be a distribution center and a key link in commerce between the United States and Mexico.
That was one of the dreams, that was one of the things that we saw when we were forming the chamber, that we wanted to be recognized among other communities and be part of the community as a whole. The success has been, you know, where Hispanic businesses have united, but also they're working, you know, across the board, you know, with other communities within the community.
We unified the Chambers of Commerce of Southern Arizona with the Chambers of Commerce in Sonora, but obviously the chamber has grown into something very large and impactful in our community.
I remember all of us getting the building and then going with our asadores and our rakes and trying to start pulling weeds and cleaning, and we all did it. We all volunteered because we were so passionate about the Hispanic community and about the chamber.
To all the people that started it, they were diligent, they stuck it out, they promoted the Hispanic community, which was important to us at the time, because we didn't want to be forgotten. The Hispanic community was kind of being put aside, so I believe that through the chamber, it grew.
Tucson, because of its bicultural nature, has, and because of its geographical nature, has great potential to continue to grow in the international marketplace.
De veras tenemos una gran deuda para los fundadores de la Cámara de Comercio. The visionaries that made it all happen. Rico Sotomayor, Frank Salazar, Bobby Boyo, Pablo Ortiz, las familias Palafox and Avitia, who worked so hard for this chamber. And of course, all the past board members, all the volunteers, all the corporate and small businesses who have supported this chamber for so long. They're the ones that really deserve so much of the credit for the success of the Hispanic Chamber of Commerce.
We'd all scramble to bring, you know, people together so that we could create a chamber that people could go and the chamber could help them. For everyone who helped get started with the Hispanic Chamber, si se puede, si se pudo, y lo hicimos. Muchas gracias, buenas noches.